What's up, y'all? I'm José James here in Electric Garden with the legendary Ben Kane and Brian Bender. I want to talk about the first track on my new album, No Beginning, No End 2, which is also the first single, I Need Your Love. Started as just like a little fiddly guitar demo of me playing two chords, which evolved to three chords. For me, coming from jazz and also being a child of the hip hop era, as you guys are too, it's important to sort of have the looseness of jazz, but like the sounds, the real sounds of like hip hop and R&B, which is why we came to you. Yeah, tell me about that room. Like, how did you set it up to get that sound and that feeling? You know what I mean?
Yeah, well, where we placed the drums in the corner there, it's kind of a dead, the walls behind it are dead, so it keeps it pretty tight, and then there's a curtain that can come in and out to kind of change up how much of the room sounds. It's the big sound of the room sounds great as it is, and it's not too roomy or like too far. So if you want that, you can have that atmosphere. But you know, usually once they start going, you kind of adjust how open and closed those curtains are to get the right amount of liveness.
Let's hear those drums in isolation.
Yeah, let's hear them.
Justin Brown on the drums. Bay Area, stand up.
And then again, like some of the, I feel like some of the instrument choices really inform some of the connection to the hip hop diaspora, right? Like this snare drum, I'm immediately thinking Questlove. You know, like that tuning. Were those choices that you guys were making on the day, or was that stuff that Justin just did automatically?
We had a few snares to choose from, and I know we kind of went between them for the different songs.
Right.
Sometimes he'd start on one, and as we kind of moved from there and played it through with the band, it was like, you know what, let's switch to the another one.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
I don't think this was a piccolo, it was just kind of a tight tuning on a larger drum, yeah.
It's just jazz.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, I mean, for me, it's more about the player. That's why I like working with both of you, because I think we support the musician rather than the other way around. It's like, well, you gotta play this kit, this sound, and I feel like musicians kind of like are in a funny place where they come in, you know, Justin didn't write that song, for example, right? It's my song. And a lot of the stuff was added later. Like we added Lettucey later, we added Christian Scott later, we added some of my vocals later,
yeah.
A lot of post-production. So all they know is they have to play a beat that feels good,
right.
You know? Mm-hmm. And when, you know, when you hear it now, it's like the full realization, but I always want to make sure the musicians feel comfortable. And if they're like, yo, I'm really feeling this, whatever, Ludwig, or like whatever thing they want to do, I always let them try it at least. Before I shut it down, you know what I mean? I think in the beginning of my career, I was more controlling. And I think that's a thing with younger artists. You're like, oh, it's gotta be like this, because I saw, you know, Questlove do this, or Chris Dave do this. But really respecting the musicians, and that's why we're here.